In the last few videos, we explored a situation where the aggregate demand curve shifted to the right, and that caused inflation. And that's actually called demand pull inflation. What I want to do in this video is study a situation where the short run aggregate supply curve shifts to the left, and that causes inflation. And that's called cost push inflation. Cost push inflation. So let's just start off with our standard graph. So this is aggregate prices. This is real aggregate productivity, real GDP right over here. And I'm going to focus things on the short run. Aggregate demand right over here, that is our aggregate demand curve. And then our aggregate supply in the short run, this is what we're going to focus on, might look something like that. So this is aggregate supply in the short run. And this is our current level. This is our current level of prices. And the reason why I draw aggregate supply in the short run having this curve that keeps getting steeper and steeper, or if you think in algebraic terms, the slope gets larger and larger as you go to the right. One way to think about it, if the real GDP is down here, maybe performing well below its potential, there's a lot of excess capacity in the economy, excess labor capacity, excess factory capacity. And then if you want more productivity out of that economy, people aren't going to demand much more. Prices won't have to go up more. There's a lot of slack in the economy. While as GDP gets higher and higher, maybe even going beyond its potential, starts to get overheated, in order for people to get to very, very high levels of utilization, or essentially get more people to enter into the labor market or work longer hours, work overtime, the prices are essentially going to have to go up. So over here, for some increment in GDP, prices don't have to go up so much. So you have a lower slope than, say, over here. For that same increment in GDP, prices have to go up dramatically. Now, with that out of the way, let's think about what would happen if the aggregate supply curve were to shift to the left. And we could also think about why would it shift to the left. So let's first just shift it to the left. It might look something like that. So at any given point, I just tried to shift it to the left. And you see a new aggregate, you see a new equilibrium price and equilibrium GDP. This was the old equilibrium price and the old equilibrium real GDP. This is the new equilibrium price and the new equilibrium real GDP. And you see, you definitely had inflation. Price went up. But this is worse than, or depending on how you view things, but in general, this is worse than the demand pull inflation. Because at least with the demand pull inflation, we saw that over here, you had inflation happening, but GDP, real GDP, increased even more. It started to get overheated. But over here, you have the other way around. Prices went up. But your GDP actually contracts. And this is a situation that you might have heard the word before. This is stagflation, inflation with stagnation. So this is stagflation. And there's two very notable examples of this in recent US history. In 1973, you had the Arab oil embargo. It was apparently due to respond to US support of Israel in the Yom Kippur War. So you had the 1973 oil embargo. And in 1979, you have your revolution in Iran. Iran was a major oil producer then, continues to be, but it was even more significant in 1979. And so during all the chaos during the revolution, Iran's oil productivity dropped dramatically. And so you had an oil crisis. And the reason why oil crises would shift the cost, would shift the curve to the left, oil crisis. So in both of these situations, the supply of oil drops dramatically. And so if the supply of oil, and this is kind of a micro phenomenon, if the supply of something drops dramatically, the price of that thing is going to go up dramatically. And in the 70s, oil was even a bigger part of the US economy than it is now. You probably remember, if you were around in the 70s, very, very large cars that had very bad gas mileage. And other uses of oil were also much, much less efficient in the 1970s. So it was a big input into the US economy. And if all of a sudden a major input's price becomes much, much more expensive, then you could view it one of two ways. For a given level of productivity, suppliers will want to charge more. If you want me to deliver this to your house, if you want me to run your truck, so for a given level of productivity, suppliers would charge more. So you could view it like that. Or you could view at a given level of price, suppliers will want to produce less. So at a given price, so let's say this price right over here, a supplier would want to produce less because they're not getting as much real profit. And so you could view it as a shift to the left, or you could even view it if you say at a given level of productivity, if you want me to produce at that level, you're going to have to pay me more to offset my price increases. So you could also view it as a shift up. Either one, but we'll think of it as a shift left in this context. And so you see, this does describe what happened during these two oil crises in the 1970s. Because of this increase in the price of oil, at any given price, suppliers were willing to supply left. Short-run aggregate supply shifts to the left. You have the inflation, and you also have the stagnation. Real GDP goes down.